Hey, so in light of the fact that this pandemic is never going to end, I might as well spend my last days on Earth knowing how to make prosthetics, so that's what we're doing today. Our first task is making a face cast, so I have a product to mold this prosthetic onto. I have plaster cloth, I have water here, and I'm wearing clothes that I don't mind getting messy.
The first thing we have to do is coat our face in Vaseline. This is important because you have a million little hairs on your face, and the plaster is apparently just gonna rip all that off. Adding a generous amount to your eyebrows, because that's quite a lot of hair to have ripped off. And you have the option of not covering your eyes when you do this mask. I'm choosing to do so. I'm literally talking all over your face, like literally your lips and like all that. Plastic bag is literally just to protect my hair and like all my baby hairs and all that. This wrap is capable of just being cut. You just dip it in the water and it's just gonna turn mushy. Woo! Not gonna lie, this is sort of a vibe. So you will like go over your nose and under your nose and like get all these little skin areas beneath your nose, but the one thing you do not fill yet is your nostrils, because you are covering your mouth in a second and you need to breathe. And now, I'm going to be signing off. Goodbye. I did not use enough Vaseline, folks. Okay, so pulling it off, I do see here that I missed some bits. This is the bit where you go over your mask and fill in all those holes that you either didn't fill in or you missed. The tutorials look so much nicer than mine. I don't know, I've never done this before. Mostly what's important is the inside, because like that's the mold part. Okay, so now we're actually doing the pour. I have this supported by just some plastic bags in a box. What you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna take Vaseline and you're gonna wanna soak your actual mold in that. This is going to make it easier to free the cast from the mold at the end. Now, once it's all sufficiently gooped, then you want to take your actual casting material. This is plaster of Paris. This is 2 parts plaster, 1 part water. Now, the plaster says it has a half hour setting time, but because this is such a dense amount of plaster, it's probably going to take several hours. So I'll see y'all on the flip side when this dries. This is the creepiest thing I've ever seen. This looks like a death mask. This is, I think, how they make death masks. Anyhow, well, we have to do the next bit now. Now I'm just kind of wiping all the Vaseline off of the cast, since there's some left over from when we pulled it out of the mold. And now you can just take some sandpaper and just file off all these ugly edges here. And make sure you take a lot of care with this step, because you're really only wanting to grind away like the rough edges and the bubble places, things like that. You're not trying to grind away any of the real actual curves that reflect your face. Okay, I think I'm about satisfied with this, where it's at. It's not perfect. If I had it to do over, I'd do some things differently. I should have definitely packed the bandages tighter around the curves of my face, because I can definitely tell there's some places where the bandages went limp by the time it dried. But I think for the most part, it's loyal enough to my curves that I can get away with making a prosthetic with this. this. I'm going to coat this in several layers of Mod Podge. What this is going to do is it's going to fill any small little air bubbles that are left over, and it's going to give me a nice slick surface to put latex on. So this is the finished product. Not going to win any awards, but for our purposes it will work, because what we're going to do to build our prosthetics is we're going to build onto it with modeling clay. And so any curves or imperfections that we're experiencing in the actual mold can be adjusted with that clay, and that is how we're going to create this prosthetic. So stay tuned for that bit.